No, it's just huge, obviously, on the continent.
I know what you're saying. It's one of those things where it's... No, I don't like it.
Yo, speaking of sharks, did you see the clip of like recently of the guy who's like diving underwater and the visibility is kind of low? And he like turns around and a fucking great white shark comes and like hits him in the head and like doesn't bite him or anything, but like, and even the great white shark's like, whoa, fuck, and like kind of like swims away. But like, it's a big fucking shark. And oh my, I watched it and I was like, oh my, I would be traumatized and never, ever, 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 ever go in the water again. Like,
yeah, we watch,
oh my God,
we watch Shark Week with the kids all the time. So like, we watch like, so it's funny. So my oldest, Sophia, she likes the, she just likes to learn about the sharks. What's the biggest shark? How long it is? How much does it weigh? Things like that. And then my younger one, she likes to see the shark attacks. So if it's like hitting seals, she's like, nah, that's kind of boring. You know, the South African ones like jumping out of the water, you know, full 25-foot great white out of the water, airborne, and diving back in. And she's like, whatever. But you show like a beach, she's like, oh, here we go. This is it. This is the one. This is the one right here. It's going to be a shark attack. It's like, oh, that person right there. Oh, that person's going to get it. She's going to get it. She's ruthless.
Wow.
Yeah. It's like a full hour show. And it'll be like one clip of like, that one thing, she got all excited about that. As soon as that, she's like, I'm good. She'd go upstairs and play. She'd be like, all right, I saw my shark attack.
I saw someone just get massacred. Like, nice.
He almost was like a megaphone.
Hello?
It kind of works, yeah. There you go. All right, so.
We're about to play the greatest record of all time.
Yep. It's called Drum Suite, the Art Blakey Percussion Ensemble.
And it's entirely comprised of percussion.
But I swear there's lyrics in here. I swear. I heard either somebody chanting or singing. I don't know. But we're going to play in the background. And
instrumentally, though, there's just percussion.
Yeah, it's just percussion. Okay. Yeah. Okay, sorry. Sorry to the musician over here.
No,
percussionist.
No. I'm not. I'm not special.
We're all a little special.
All right.
You gonna play the right?
3, 2, 1. Yeah.
See, I told you.
Okay, fair. right out the gates. Just boom.
I thought so.
I'm getting ready.
I feel like I should be singing. So apparently we lied to you. There is no percussion. It is just chanting.
No, it's coming. It's coming. It's coming.
We only briefly heard this. Oh, here we go. Start strong.
Oh, I'm already getting the jiggies.
What I like about this, it's like traditional, like African drum with the kind of jazz ensemble.
Yeah, and if you like single out each instrument and just listen to that one, they're really kind of all just like doing some sort of groove over and over.
Yeah.
Within the same time, it's like. That's it. So, hey, let's have everybody sit in a circle and just
turn away.
Pick a speed and just start doing our thing.
Well, I think that's what's so fascinating about it, though. Oh, that's the sticks, right? So that's what we got to figure out.
Yeah, can we figure out what that instrument is?
So like two like hardened like wooden sticks.
Maybe you know. Maybe Kayla knows.
She doesn't.
All right, so it's like they're rather thick. I would say like a cucumber.
Penis shaped.
Yep. And they're this shape. and they're wooden, and that's what you're hearing. Click, 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 click,
fun
click,
fact, click, this is where click, the term get into woody comes from.
Yes.
These penis-shaped instruments from Africa. They tend to be a little bit bigger on very Africa phallic than they do in Europe.
Would you believe me if I told you they were rain sticks?
Rain sticks?
Can I see a picture?
Yeah.
Can I see a picture for 200, please?
Wow, those are very fancy. Yeah. That's not quite what I had in mind.
Think like
percussion.
Yeah. Like these things.
Yeah.
Yeah, kind of.
One but has a ribbon?
Well, that's so you can go. Brrr.
Yeah.
Do it again.
Brrr.
There you go.
They're called actually rhythm sticks, but in the tribes they call them rain sticks. How to make a rain stick?
Rain stick. Okay, that's pretty cool. So can you give us the context of a rain stick? Like what tribe?
Oh, you got some symbol.
You know what reminds me of this? Have you ever played with like a program called like Fruity Loops or like any of those like?
Yeah. Oh no, I haven't. But I know, you know what they do. Yeah,
so
yeah.
You know what you like? You have like a loop. Yeah. Like oh, let's start a loop here. Oh, this sounds pretty good. Get yeah. Yeah, good like yeah. You know yeah, like a djembe drum going, and then like oh, let's add like a little bit of jazz drum. You yeah. Got that going. Yeah. Let's get the rain sticks going over there. It's like oh, look at this. You.
You're now already, you know. You're rain kind sticks.
Of past. Yeah. Now you're past that timeline. You're like no, let's just add a little more simple to it. Why not? So you just keep throwing loops at a song. That's what this kind of sounds like.
Yeah. That's exactly what this entire
it's like
record is.
Everyone out there that has like Apple GarageBand could just make this track.
Yeah, nobody starts. I mean, if you notice, this is only the first track, I believe. We're still on the first track.
Yeah, right? I think so. I don't think it's switched over yet.
All right, it's actually the technical name via Wikipedia is a Lumi stick. L-U-M-M-I.
Lumi stick.
They're named after the Lumi Native American peoples.
Really? Okay.
And
so this is not African then.
They are hard wooden cylinder sticks,
yep.
Roughly 7 inches long,
7 inches
and
penis shape.
Mm-hmm. 0.75 inches in diameter. They're used as percussion.
0.75.
Instruments.
In diameter, really?
Mm-hmm. Seems thicker than that. Huh?
Yeah, the one.
For the record, mine's thicker.
Now we're on to a brand new topic.
Another variety of a rhythm stick is 12 inches long and some are painted.
Those are the African ones, I bet. But that's interesting. Okay, so this is a multicultural thing then. This is not like...
Yeah, they say they're similar sticks from similar or different tribes around the world.
That's pretty neat. So obviously I know nothing about, I guess, native drumming and tribe, so I'm calling it African because that's what I hear mostly in movies about Africa.
So you're being racist.
Yes, I'm being racist. No, I'm being culturalist. Culturalist. Let's call it culturalist.
Get it all out now, man. It's 2017. Still. For a few more weeks. No, I know you're not. I know.
We're not racist.
Yeah, I know.
We're culturalist.
Not even close.
No. Maybe. See, I'm drinking out of a bamboo cup.
When you lift it up, it says Pure One at the bottom.
Dang. Oh, well. Well, that's still made in China.
Yeah, we'll just scratch that out.
I like this. This is kind of almost like a Caribbean
thing. I obviously lied in the beginning of this because I said that it was entirely percussive, and clearly that is a piano.
Well, that's one of the coolest things about this is we actually never even heard of these albums.
Like, yeah,
this is the first time we're actually hearing these.
Also, the coolest thing about this is that you can't trust anything I say ever. So
that is also true. But no, this is cool. It has like a almost like a salsa feel to it. It's like a Cuban almost.
Yeah,
and there we go, being cultures again. But hey, what do I know?
No, I totally agree. It does have a.
But we got a couple more instruments here. We got some shaker.
Yeah.
Oh, so we got the piano.
We got the rain stick still.
Yeah, very deep in the background. They might not even be able to hear that. Well, this is a pretty cool album.
On Columbia Records. Wait, all right, can I just pick this up? And yeah, all right. Yeah, let's do this. Columbia, this recommends to play it on a
Columbia Phonograph.
That's right, Columbia Phonographs. That's what we're playing this record on. We actually dug up a vintage 1956 Columbia Phonograph to play this record on so we can hear it in its most clearest point.
It's actually so fragile that we can't pick it up to show you.
Unfortunately, we cannot. That is all lies, by the way. This is playing on a modern, it's like a USB, a record to MP3 converter. It's playing through a digital sound speaker as well. So it's not going to be the most authentic as what we would get on a beautiful Columbia Phonograph. But 2017, we got to do what we got
to
do.
But we still get to listen to some obscure and, at least to me, unrecognizable records.
Yeah, do we have any info on...
what year? Because that's what I'm looking for.
And I... Yeah, it's on the side there. On the
yeah, check the...
It usually says it.
I feel like I've looked at every part, and I do not see
that. Pull that up,
unless it was made in the year 1002.
There you go, people. It's the first record ever produced.
Oh, wait.
Do you have a copyright?
No.
See, what's interesting about these, some of these old records, there's a lot of times they actually don't put their copyright on because apparently back then copyright might have not been a big thing, or... We have a registered trademark and things like that on here, but... So interestingly enough...
Is that Spanish?
Sounds like it.
Vamos a bailar.
Come on, let's dance.
Yeah. I think that's what it's saying. It only took us the whole song, but we got it.
We're also multilingual on this, apparently. I don't know. We're going to get that information for you, but... Oh, I like this. We got a bass line now?
Oh, yeah.
There
we go. Oh, yeah.
1957.
Damn. Wow.
And its style is... Afro-Cuban jazz.
Literally what you said.
Afro-Cuban jazz. There we go. There you go. I'm not a racist. Apparently
you're smart.
Okay, well, that saved me and the show, so we can now continue. Can you pull up some facts about 1957? I don't really know anything about 57. I know 57 Chevys. We'll show it right here.
I don't.
57 Chevy. Pretty cool car. It's a really good collector's car. My cousin's got a nice 57 Bel Air. It's kind of the one, it was like the people's car. Like, you had the Cadillacs with those nice long tail fins coming out the back. The Bel Airs and the lower-end Chevys kind of, they still had that flair, but they were cheaper. So it would be like having, like, going out and buying, like a Chevy Cruze today, but it would have, like, the appeal of, like, it's not really... majorly cool Chevys now, but like,
yeah,
you know, maybe like, you know, or like the Malibu kind of has like the taillights inspired by the Corvette.
Yeah,
so, you know, every man can kind of get like that. So it was kind of cool car, but 1957 Chevy, as soon as you see it, it brings you back to that era. And what's cool about that is in Cuba, with the embargo, all they have is those old cars from the 50s, because when we had the embargo on Cuba, they couldn't get the parts, so they had to keep these cars running. So they just take these parts from like an old, like, you know, they had Russian cars, like an old like Dacia, or like an old like a tractor like battery from there, and then maybe like a camshaft from over here, and they put it back into these American cars because that's all they have to drive around in. So they're just keeping these things going, and it's so fascinating that if you actually know Cuba kind of now and you listen to this, it's still technically the same. Like, it really hasn't changed.
Have you been to Cuba?
I haven't. I want to go so bad, though.
I have never been either. And I also, I don't know very much about
cars. Because it's always been like a...
It's like speaking Japanese to me.
Japanese?
Something else about 1957 is the Federation of Melia gains independence from Great Britain on August 31st.
I want to say one of my parents was born in 57.
Yeah, my dad was actually.
57, yeah.
57, yeah.
Another thing is that the USSR launches Sputnik.
Sputnik, yeah, there we go.
The first artificial Earth satellite.
Yeah, that started everything. That started the space race.
That happened on October 4th.
Yeah, because we went to the moon in 69, right?
Yeah. So
57 was the first.
Russia was so far ahead of us at that time, too. Because you got to think, they already had a satellite launched in orbit, meaning stuck out there, and can relay messages back and forth. We didn't even have anything at that point. We barely probably even had a space program. We're probably working on something, but I don't think we had an official space program then. Because I don't even think NASA was even started until like the 60s, right? 61-ish? 62? I don't know.
And now, a day short of a month later, the USSR launches Sputnik 2 with a dog. And it was the first animal ever to be in orbit.
And he died. What was the dog's name? Was it Sputnik?
No, it was...
They actually had the dog's name?
L-A-I-K-A.
L-A-I-K-A. Laika?
Laika.
Laika. Maybe it was a female.
Yeah.
Why a dog?
Why not?
I don't know why a dog.
It's Russia.
That's fair.
What else are they going to send? A bear?
Trust dog. We send dog to space.
We send monkeys, right? Chimps?
Yeah.
Space
yeah.
chimps. We like one dog. Like we want not the Russians. Like, oh, you sent the dog. We're just going to send a space chimp.
Yeah.
A little bit more intelligent. They had humans in space before we did, too. So they were so far advanced, and the whole, you know...
We could go down a serious K-hole.
Yeah, we probably could.
With the direction that this conversation is going.
But, no, it's just fascinating that, like, Russia was so far ahead. And that was 1957. Think about how far ago that was, and where we are now. And
how advanced almost 2018.
We're going to Mars. Well, not now, but soon. All right, continue, please. Sorry.
If we're not already.
That's another show.
Yeah. Different podcast, guys. Sorry.
December 18th.
December 18th. All right. It's coming up.
World's first full-scale nuclear power plant begins to generate electricity at the shipping port atomic power station in Pennsylvania. So it was the first.
Wow, first nuclear power plant.
Yeah.
1957. So this was, again, obviously Cold War era where nuclear was like the best and brightest thing. I remember seeing something online, and this could not be true, I don't know, but they used to sell products with uranium and like iridium in them, and like as health products, like meaning like chew this like uranium gum and it'll like whiten your teeth. This was a thing, like they would sell like kits to like kids, and they would have like all these, I don't know, like toys that you could play with.
That's interesting because it's been proven that there are like beneficial effects to consuming certain minerals.
And also radiation poison, which will kill you.
Yes.
Right? Yeah.
On the flip side, yes.
Or superpowers.
Yeah, who knows? Maybe you turn into the Hulk.
Yeah, that's true. That's radiation poison. Yeah. So that's why we won. No, never mind. I'll just say that's why we won World War II.
Because the Hulk.
Yeah, because we had super soldiers.
We had the Hulk. No, the actual Hulk.
We have some technical difficulties here. Well, I guess back to the music over here, but
I really love how much percussion there is.
Are you biased towards percussion?
I'm a drummer, but I'm obviously not biased just because I'm a drummer.
I am not a musician whatsoever. However, I do enjoy percussion.
We're gonna get in on this.
Yeah, there you go. Let's get a little be going. Pick it up. Pick it up.
I don't know what that noise was.
That was the electronic noise. heard the gong, right?
Is that what that was?
I think it was a gong. We have a gong. Oh. The backup dancers. So I'm kind of enjoying this album. I kind of like the drum suite, the Art Blakey percussion ensemble.
Yeah, with the kind of jazz piano behind it.
It's like
I like this. I could just put this, listen to this as background music, really doing anything.
It's good, kind of like study music, or I don't want to say elevator.
I want to be driving an old car. Like one of the old longer styles cars.
Yeah. In Cuba.
Like down the PCH in California while it's raining, which never happens. But
why not the Cuban coastline?
Or the Cuban crash line. That's perfect while this is playing. Yeah. Not in my car, just as the soundtrack of what's happening in my life. You know? That's what I want.
I think that was side one. Do we have a side two?
We do.
So, how many songs total do we have on it?
I don't know anything. So, all right, this is going to be my millennial moment.
The first side is the drum suite.
Yeah, I don't know how to read these record jackets. Like, because there's so much text on them.
Yeah.
And I don't want to be lazy and not read it all, but, like, I'm just looking for that quick. Is there just, like, a quick, like, song list?
So, this is side two?
Yes.
So now we're on to the jazz messengers.
Wait. So this is going to be all jazz now.
The jazz messengers. Infrared.
No, you listen to side two first.
We listen to side two first?
No, I don't believe that.
No way. That can't be. No, because No. The names of the songs.
Yeah.
On the drum suite side.
This is definitely.
Worth a sacrifice, Cubano chant.
Oscar Lipson.
Yeah. So this is side two, the jazz messengers. So this is Nika's tempo. That's what we're listening to right now.
That is pretty cool.
I like it. I like it so far. Music is shit. Compared to what it used to be.
It definitely is.
So much more thought put into all this. You know, they don't just loop something. Don't get me wrong, looping things is very fun.
But to be in all fairness, though, I feel like I could make this song in food loops or in...
this one we're listening to right now.
Maybe not this one because I'm not that good, but the more percussion one, I feel like I could. I could throw that. I bet you I could make a pretty convincing version.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
Just based on the loops, but I would agree with you. It takes a lot of thought to have these runs. Those are your vocals.
But also, like, what's the adjective word? I don't think adjective is the word I'm looking for either, but... It's like a collective thought. You know what I mean? Like,
yes.
Like doing it together. That's the amazing part. Like any machine or program can do it all on its own, but like getting other people with all these different minds to do it together and like create something like this is so cool. And it's just, I feel like it's not something you see as much of. You know? Like, yeah, it happens, but it's like.
Yeah, there's a few. Boom, boom. Although I am a fan of what's that band there? I can't forget. But they do like a cross between. It's almost like a house slash like dance and like a Native American. It's a pretty cool. Like I know like the few songs they have is like Mama Coupier. It's like the Hallucination.
I bet you my brother would know, but I.
It's some rap music, but yeah, but we're talking obscure music out there in the fringes of Spotify that I come across. I think I actually came across this from a video game, and I happened to like the song, and I ended up finding it in the album.
Is it like electronic?
Oh, it definitely is. It's percussion with
So
it's kind of a little bit more beyond that, but yeah, you're never gonna hear this on radio. No. Unless it's a oldie, old-timey,
Like jazz station.
Yeah, like on like a really low state. Like, it'd be like 88.2. 2 or something like that. College radio, or like just some guy in his basement just doing it for fun.
So, this album actually goes for about $40, $40 to $50 right now. I'm looking at around on eBay, and they're around $40 to $50.
Well, I think that's a steal. Because this is a pretty awesome record.
This is a pretty badass album.
Interestingly enough, some of them, people that say they have them, it says it's coming from like Japan or coming from the United Kingdom.
Really? So
yeah, so it's they're global.
Man, I got a
global album. Is album the right word, or do you say vinyl or record?
LP? I don't know. I don't know what the correct term is, and I'm sure if anyone watching this, if you want to correct us on this, LP?
Well, you know, you can correct us if you'd like. I personally don't care. I'm going to call it a record because it is a record.
Right, so album is a record. Incorrect. Record would be the incorrect.
Well, technically it's an album.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a composition of multiple songs, so that constitutes as an album, I think. So side note, sidebar, but still on the topic of this record, something about jazz induces a literal like feeling.
Yeah.
To me, like
I understand. I know exactly what you're saying. It does.
Like I don't know how to describe it really, or. It's good. It's a good feeling, but it's a very different. It's like a maybe it's making different synapses go off in my brain.
That's what for me. It's I like it because it gives me new channels and avenues to think about.
Yeah.
Because listening to this, you listen to the horn, and I said it before. It's like it's almost the lyrics of the song. So a lot of times I'll listen to it and you kind of almost make your own lyrics, your own story to the song, your own. It's your song now, kind of in a sense.
But it, I mean, like, it almost like just does something to the atmosphere. Like when we were just talking,
is it 5 minutes ago?
I don't know. Maybe I'm just stoned, but like.
Or it could just be like every movie you ever watched, like every time you were in somewhere cool.
Yeah, maybe it's like
jazz.
A nostalgia thing. That could be.
This
anyway.
This guy was one happy guy, too. He's always, Art Blakey,
look at that.
Yeah? The only one I can really see from here, he's not smiling.
Yeah, can you blow up one of those images?
Yeah!
It looks like Bill Cosby a little bit.
Yeah!
No.
Racist.
Two super
ones? Oh, yeah. He's got the whole drummer face. Yeah.
You pull one of those in your day?
Oh my gosh, yeah.
He's got a cool drum set.
Yeah, he's a Gretsch guy. All right.
Gretsch? What does that mean?
I like Gretsch,
that's the brand of drums. Yeah, it says it on the top of his kick drum.
As he kicks the drum.
Oh, that was good.
So this is him. Yeah, Gretsch is good. My man is playing.
And this is 1957, too.
He was doing that with a cigarette in his mouth.
That's the only way to do it. I bet you by the time this solo is over, he finished that cigarette. And then right here,
that was good. Yep. Right when the music kicked back in, he would spit it out of his mouth.
Yeah,
love it.
See, and then someone put another one in his mouth and lit it for him while he was playing.
And that's the feeling. That's that cool vibe. Like this is that. You'll still be listening to this driving down there.
Yeah,
that Cuban song.
Yeah, it's a vibe. It definitely is a vibe. The jazz brings to a room and to a crowd.
It almost gives you like special powers. Like
it just it's a happy. It's like
imagine like I would. Love,
I can't imagine anybody getting in a fight at a bar that jazz was playing in.
Oh, it depends on the kind of jazz, I guess, right?
Yeah, I guess that's
it. if you went big band, you could. If you kind of went that more avenue,
yeah,
I could see that like a. Kind of rouse it up a little bit.
Yeah, I guess that was a kind of stupid thing to say because you could get in a fight listening to anything.
But imagine like just putting headphones on to that and walking down like a busy street just walk down to it, and you'll find yourself just strutting. Your chest to be out, you'll be strutting. Just based on the music and the feeling itself. It's one of those...
It's it induces like a happy confidence. Yeah. It's like not even a confidence, just like a whatever.
Yeah, it's like, yeah, I'm listening to jazz. What about it? You know? You want to fight? There you go. There's your jazz fight.
What's up? I'm 2 feet taller than most people.
That's more of a
no
Boston
big deal.
Thing, but
stick out like a sore thumb.
But yeah, it definitely has a
we're getting into other things now. Yeah, oh, definitely. That's back to the vibe. Just kinda...
That was pretty cool. I like that.
Yeah. Ba-da, ba-da, boom, boom. Yeah. Copy.
So, I don't know. I think I like this album a lot.
Are we doing a star rating? Are we doing like a 1 through 10?
Yeah.
Or do we do some sort of metaphoric rating?
Let's do a metaphoric rating. Let's do like on a scale of like pandas to spaceships.
Pandas being awesome?
I don't know. Pandas and Spaceships are pretty awesome, too.
Yeah, you're talking two awesome things here.
Well, it's a pretty awesome album. I don't know. If, like, on a scale of pandas to spaceships, I'd give it like a 7 panda to spaceship ratio.
I would say that this record is a young, wise panda in a spacesuit.
Oh.
Somewhere in orbit around Earth. Yeah.
That's pretty bad.
I can't keep a straight face. Nah.
All right, so I'd give it a 7 out. Yeah. I like that. Space Panda. So
Space Panda, yep.
The reading.
$40?
Worth the $40.
$40?
Yeah. For Space Panda? Absolutely.
This is perfect for like background music.
But you know what's cool about
perfect.
It?
Perfect. You have some people over. Boop, put that on. You're classy. Boom. Instant class.
But then you flip over while
you can shit on a plate and serve it with a spoon to your guests. As long as you're playing this, you're still classy.
They'll fucking eat that shit right up.
You're classy. They're going to be like, hoo, chocolate mousse.
And then for your after dinner kind of soiree, you flip it over. You got those drum beats.
Oh, yeah. It. You're dancing.
Yeah.
You're jiving. You're grooving.
You're space pandering out there. So
you're space pandering.
For $40, I would say absolutely. And I guess we could definitely recommend it. A space
again,
panda worthiness album like this is one of the better ones. So I guess that's it.
Also, excellent album art.
Well, of course, look at that.
I'm into it.
Helmets and statues.
Simple.
I like it. But the ratings in, the review, the listening, the craziness, I think we're going to sign off. So thumbs up for this one.
Drum Suite and Art Blakely and the Jazz Messengers.
Thumbs up?
I give it a thumbs up.
All right, there you go. Space Panda worthy.